Welcome to the demo session of ARM. In this session, students, you will be going to learn different addressing modes, that is various addressing modes of ARM, various addressing modes of ARM. Let me take you to the blackboard. So ARM 7 operates on 7 addressing modes. The 7 addressing modes are as follows. But before continuing, what is a addressing mode? Addressing mode is nothing but the manner operand is given, the manner operand is given in an instruction. The manner operand is given in an instruction. Then what is operand? Operand is the value on which you want to operate. Operand is the value on which you want to operate, and the manner operand is given, the way operand is given in the instruction is called as addressing modes. So there are 7 addressing modes are there. Those are immediate addressing mode, register addressing mode, direct addressing mode, indirect addressing mode, register relative addressing mode, base index addressing mode, base with scaled index mode. These are the 7 addressing modes. So we will see one by one how it works. Let us take first immediate addressing mode. So immediate addressing mode. Now the instruction for the immediate addressing mode, the example is given here. That is move R0, #25H. In the immediate addressing mode, data is given in the instruction itself. The data is given in the instruction itself. So here you can see this instruction contains data. The processor, no need to get the data from the memory. The data is there in the instruction itself. So here R0 will get 25. Similarly, second instruction, add R0, R1, #25H. That means R0 is nothing but the addition of R1 plus 25. So H indicates is the hexadecimal value. So any number preceded by hash indicates the data. If there is no hash, then that number indicates the address. Now, students, you have to remember the one point here. We know like the instruction, all instructions of ARM are 32 bit. So in that 32 bit, some parts of the in that 32 bit, some bits are allocated for operand or opcode, some bits are allocated for opcode, some bits are allocated for register. So some bits are allocated for data. That means the maximum data size data you can mention here in the instructions are 8 bit. You cannot mention 32 bit data directly over here. If you mention 32 bit data, then where is the place for opcode and this one other register? So that means you cannot mention 32 bit data directly. You have to mention maximum 8 bit data. Suppose you want to mention 32 bit data, then use the other mode. There are other modes also. Use the other mode. So that is the one thing you have to remember. Now, second one, register addressing mode. Now register addressing, in the register addressing mode, you are going to give data through register. Once again, the example, move R0, R1. R0 will get the value from R1. In the previous example, you have given data in the instruction itself. Here you are giving data through register. Add R0, R1, R2. It is a triadic instruction. That means R0 is nothing but the addition of R1 and R2. So this addressing mode is called the register addressing mode because we are using the register here. So this addressing mode is faster compared to the other addressing mode also because you are using register directly. Next one, we will move to the next one. The next addressing mode is direct addressing mode. So why the name direct addressing mode? In the direct addressing mode, we will mention the address in the instruction itself. Here you can see this is the address we are going to mention. So this is here in this instruction, this is the variable. So in while writing program, we will create the variable in the memory, and if we will mention that variable, our assembler and our compiler, while assembling or compiling, convert this variable into address, and that address is given to the register R0. That's why the name direct addressing mode, because at the end of the day we are mentioning address here. That's why this is called direct addressing mode. So now, since it's related to addressing mode, so here, since we are using memory, so you know ARM, in ARM only two instructions work with memory, that is, one is LDR, second one is STR. So LDR and STR. So here, LDR means load register, STR means store register. So here, LDR R0, amount means R0 is loaded with address. STR R0, amount means the content of R0 is stored in this location. The content of R0 is stored in this location. So you need to remember once again, ARM instructions are 32-bit instruction. So ARM instructions are 32-bit instruction. So this address cannot be 32-bit. If it is once again 32-bit, if you assign 32-bit address, then now the question comes, where the other part of the instruction will occupy. So the maximum bits allocated for this address is 12 bits, and that is also called as offset or displacement address. That means we are going to mention here offset address or displacement address. You know what is offset address? Offset address or displacement, not base address or not actual address. You are going to mention here relative address or offset address. So next one is indirect addressing mode. Indirect addressing mode, example LDR R0, bracket R1, square bracket R1, STR R0, square bracket R1. So if you just write R1, then it gives data. If you write R1 inside the bracket, then this means address. So LDR R0, bracket R1 means the content of that address will be transferred. For example, this is the memory. Think this is the memory, and this is the address 2000. Address 2000, and this got this address has got some value 15. So I have assigned R1 is equal to 2000. Think like that. R1 is equal to 2000. Now LDR R0, bracket of 2000 means whatever there in that 2000 location, that is 15, will be going to transfer to R0. So R0 becomes 15. R0 will not become 2000. R0 will become 15. Similarly, store R0, bracket R1. The content of R0 is stored in the address location pointed by R1. So R1 is here 2000. So R0 content is stored in 2000 location. That is the meaning. This is called as an indirect addressing mode. This is why this is called as an indirect addressing mode. So students, so far we have discussed immediate addressing mode, then register addressing mode, direct addressing mode, indirect addressing mode. So now the left out is register relative addressing mode, then base index addressing mode, base with scaled index addressing mode. We'll see one by one. So students, now we'll move to register relative addressing mode. So normally register relative addressing mode, like base indexed addressing mode and base with scaled index addressing mode, comes in three version. What is that three version? The three version is normal, pre-index and post-index. Register relative addressing mode. What do you mean by register relative address? Relative addressing mode. So for that, we'll go back. In indirect addressing mode, you are just mentioning the address here. I mean, like this indicates the address. Actually, R1 in the bracket indicates the address. That means R0 will get the address is found by R1 here. But in the next case, address is not only found by R1, It is also formed by with R1 plus displacement or the plus displacement or offset, that is called as a relative addressing mode. So R1 is with relative to 04, that is called as a relative addressing mode. So there are three versions here: normal, free index, post index. What is the difference between this one? Let's consider with the example LDR, load register. So this R0 will get the data. R0 will get the data from R1 plus 04. Suppose assume in our case R1 is 2000. So R1 plus 4 is 2004. So R0 will get the data from 2004, but R1 remains same. Now the second one is pre-index mode. In the pre-index mode, we are using the instruction, once again same instruction with the explanation, that means bang sign or explanation. So here, what is the meaning of this one? Here the meaning is, here first R1 will get incremented by 4. R1 will get incremented with 4. That means, what is the value of R1 here? R1 is 2000. So now R1 becomes 2004. R1 becomes 2004. Then the content of the 2004 is transferred to R0. So content of 2004 is transferred to R0, and R1 will also get incremented first. So R1 is 2004. In the earlier case, R1 will not change and you will get the value from 2004. But here R1 will change and you will get the value from 2004. In the third case, that is the post index, here anything in the bracket means address. Now here R1 is 2000. That means you will get the content from 2000. You will get the content from address 2000. Then after that, R1 will be incremented by 4. First you will get the content from 2000. First R0 will get the content from 2000. After that R1 becomes 2004. So we see the three cases. In the first cases, you will get the content from 2004. R1 will not change. In the second case, R1 will change and you will get the content from 2004. In the third case, you will get the value from 2000 first. Then R1 will get incremented with 2004. So that is the difference between normal version, free index version and post index version. Now, what is the use of this one? Suppose you are going to access an array. Just think like you are going to access an array. So this is the array 2000, 2001, 2002, 2003, 2004, 2005. So many elements are there, like 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 8. So first I will point R1 to 2000. I want to access so many elements from the array one by one. I want to access, like, so first when you access 2000, the next location you are going to access is 2004, because ARMs are 32 bit instruction. For that, you will write R1 is equal to R1 plus 4. You need to write instruction something like this. But here the instructions are created in such a way that it will transfer the content from 2000 and automatically get incremented to the 2004. That means now your array is pointing to 2004. So such a both instructions, normal instructions are built in the single instruction. That is an advantage of this method. So there are normal version, pre-index version and post index version. So the next method or the next addressing mode is base index addressing mode. Base indexed addressing mode, one register acts like a base and other register acts like an index. For example, like we have array at the address 2000, and you want to access various elements of this array. So in that case, first R1 is initialized, that is with base value, then R2 acts like index. Each time you are going to increment the value of R2 to access the different element of the array. So as I explained earlier, this method also got three versions of three versions. One is the normal version, second one is the free index version, third one is the forced index version. For our reference, we will take the R1 value is equal to 2000 and R2 value is equal to 5. So in the first case, R0 will get the value from the combination of R1 plus R2. Here R1 is nothing but R1 plus R2, that is 2000 plus 5, that is 2005, that is 2005. So R0 will get the value from this address. So the content of this address will be transferred to R0, but R1 and R2 remain same, it will not change. In the case of free index addressing mode, here first R1 becomes 2005. First R1 becomes 2005. Then the content of 2005 is transferred to R0. In the earlier case, R1 will not change. R1 remains 2000 only. But in the second case, R1 becomes 2005. In the third case, that is called the forced index, first the content of 2000 is transferred to R0. The content of 2000 is transferred to R0. So anything in the bracket means address. Here R1 in the bracket means address. The content of 2000 is transferred to R0. After that, R1 becomes R1 plus R2. So three cases. In the first cases, like you will get the value from 2005, R1 and R2 will not change. In the second cases, first R1 will get incremented to 2005 and the value will be transferred to R0. In third cases, first the value from the 2000 will be transferred to R0, then R1 and R2, then R1 will get incremented to 2005. So these are the three cases of three versions of Waze index addressing mode. Now we will move to the last one. Students, now we'll see the last one. This is called the Waze with the scaled index addressing mode. Scaled index addressing mode. So here, here also three versions are there, like LDR, free index, and forced index. So first, let me read for the instruction LDR R0, R1, R2, LSL, ash 4. Now here, R0 will get the content from the address formed by R1 plus R2, but before adding R2 to R1, R2 will be left shifted by 4. That is, here R1 is address is formed, R1 is equal to R1 plus R2 left shifted by 4. R2 left shifted by 4, that is called as LSL, left logical shift left, LSL by 4 times. You know what is the use of left shifting? Left shiftings are used in indexing mode. So what is the use of left shifting? Like suppose if you take 0001, if you left shift it 0010, the value gets increased. You see this is 2, 0100, this becomes 4, 100, this becomes 8. So left shifting means upgrading. Right shifting means a downgrading. So here you are going to use left shift. What is the use of this left shift? Suppose you want to form the address. You want to I want to in 2567 this address location, some data is there. I want to get the address from this location 2567. How will you get the address? So to get this address, first I will initialize R1 with the 25. Then what I will do is I will left shift R1 by so that it becomes 2 times, so that it becomes 2500. For that I will add 67, so that total address becomes 2567. From this address I will get the data. So it is used, you know, the architecture of ARM. In the architecture of ARM, ALU get the value from two registers. One is directly from the register, and other one is through barrel shifter. What is the purpose of the barrel shifter? Barrel shifter makes use of indexing, barrel shifter will do shifting operation. Why it is done? What is the necessity is to improve the performance. So this barrel shifter make use of this addressing mode. So in the exam, they may ask which addressing mode is used with the base with the, which addressing mode is used in barrel shifter. Base with the scale index addressing mode is used in the barrel shifter. So next in pre-indexing mode, R1 will get changed. That is, first R1 will get changed to R1. Sorry, R1 will get changed to R1 plus R2 left shift with the 4, and from that content the value will be moved to R0. This is same as earlier method also. In the force index, first you will get the value from the R2, then sorry, first you will get the value from R1, then later R1 will be changed to R1 plus R2 left shift with the 4. So these are the different methods to move the data to the data. So far we have studied now different methods of this one, addressing mode. Let me repeat once again. So there are 7 different types of addressing modes are there. You have seen what is immediate addressing mode, what is register addressing mode, what is relative addressing mode, indirect addressing mode, register and relative addressing mode, base index addressing mode, and base with the scaled index addressing mode. Thank you for your cooperation.